The Steve Malzberg Show, 800-321-8828.
Mamas teaching angels how to sing. Heaven's halls are silent when Mama sings. David lays down his.
And that beautiful music that you're hearing is from the Isaacs. They are a multi-award-winning family group who, get this, they have been around singing for more than 30 years, and they have won multi awards, just to give you an idea. Their CD, Naturally, it has been in the top 10 Billboard bluegrass charts for over a year, not just a week or two, but over a year. That's a huge accomplishment in the music world. And the Isaacs Christmas CD, which was really beautiful, I was listening to it, stayed in the top 10 Billboard bluegrass charts during the whole Christmas season. So these are big hitters, and they're also just amazing people with an amazing story. And joining us now is Sonia Isaacs. Congratulations. How you doing?
Hi, I'm doing great. How are you doing?
I'm doing fantastic. I had the pleasure of actually speaking before you when we were at the National Quartet Convention there in Louisville. And it was just, it was awesome to hear you guys and to watch the fans. They were spellbound.
Oh, well, thank you. We certainly enjoyed hearing you speak, as always. It was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you. And your whole family, what I love about you guys, it's really all about family. It's about faith. It's about values. Why do you think, Sonia, that it's become such an important focus? Your fans are loyal in a tough economy. You guys pack the house.
Well, I think that, you know, it seems to be a trend when America gets scared and when times get tough, we sort of all want to resort to our roots of where we're safe and comfortable. And I think our music, because of the faith and really the organic sound of what we do, the sort of country bluegrass style, I think it makes people feel safe in an economy that's certainly unsafe. And we just have some of the best fans in the world. We really do.
Well, you're going to have a new fan soon, too. You're pregnant, from what I understand. Congratulations.
Yes, I am. This is our first official public announcement of our pregnancy. Yes, I am. I'm 11 weeks pregnant.
That's wonderful.
And
how is life on the road? It's hard enough, the schedule you guys keep, but being pregnant and keeping up, how is that?
Well, you know, I've heard some horror stories about women who have been sick a lot, and I've been so fortunate that I haven't really had that morning sickness like everyone talks about. I've been a little more tired than normal, so the only thing that I've noticed is that I'm having to schedule in about a 30-minute nap right in the middle of the day when I just hit this point where I can't do anything else except just I need a nap. And other than that, and the fact that it's a little bit harder to stand on my feet for a couple hours, I guess I'm going to have to somehow find some pretty nice flats singing. My heels just aren't going to cut it any longer.
Well, speaking of flats, by the way, Rascal Flatts, Jimmy, your husband, co-wrote the current Rascal Flatts number one song, Why Wait? I mean, you guys have written some huge hits. I mean, you know, regularly contributing to, Dolly Parton, Brad Paisley, Vince Gill, you know, I mean, everybody, you name it. You were a background singer for Miley Cyrus and Billy Ray Cyrus. What do you think it is about the longevity, and do you think it is because of your faith that you guys, and your mom has an incredible story. She was the child of two Holocaust survivors. There is such depth in your family.
Yes, there is. We have an amazing heritage. And, I mean, going from, you know, everything that we do is faith-based, from my husband's, meeting my husband in the first place. We've only been married for a little over a year now. We just celebrated 1 year in December. From that part to, knowing that faith got my grandparents through the Holocaust, and that, you know, faith is what brought my mom and my dad together to start singing music in the first place. And so everything that we have and are, we certainly owe to God, and we know that faith is the substance that keeps us going and brings us all of our success. God is amazing.
Tell us a little bit what's ahead schedule-wise. I know you're going to be singing, you're doing a lot with the Gaither Homecoming Tour, which is, I love them. The Gaithers are so fantastic.
Yeah.
And you guys are such a great addition, because if you haven't heard their music, everybody, you got to go to their website. It is theisaacs.com, theisaacs.com. It is fantastic. You have a very contemporary, very sort of a cool, neat mixture of stuff, and it's unusual. And I think that you appeal to so many different tastes because of it. What's ahead for you guys?
Well, thank you for saying that, by the way. That means so much to hear your compliments and your endorsement like that on the radio. We do have kind of our own sound going. We were acoustic natured. We sort of have the more contemporary style of bluegrass, sort of like Allison Krauss or Nickel Creek or those kind of people, but with the more traditional bluegrass harmonies, family harmony. And so we just love singing together. We've been together for 30 years now as a family. My siblings and I just grew up on the road when we were children. You were talking about me being on the road pregnant. My mom raised three kids and my mom and dad on the road. And so we've been singing since we were 5, 6 years old. They used to call us the little gospel chipmunks because we sang such tight harmony at young ages. But we just enjoy traveling. We have some trips. We've got a trip we're planning now to Africa in the fall. Good Lord willing, if everything goes well with the baby this summer, we're due July 29th. So we're just going to be touring. We are doing some days of shows this spring with There's the Vocal Band.
Well, I am so excited. You got a lot going on, and we're going to play out with your music here. We are honored to have you. And everybody, theisaacs.com. Awesome, awesome music, and we'll be right back.
We just can't hardly buy. Why there's even a shortage.